Timber is said to be the material of the 21st century, the material of the future, rather than steel or concrete, because steel and concrete are incredibly polluting. The cement industry is one of the biggest contributors to carbon dioxide emissions, and timber is of course carbon neutral. So my name is Gilles Retzen, I'm an architect based in London. I teach at the Bartlett School of Architecture. So the latest project is called Real Virtuality. It was combining timber construction with augmented reality. So we're using a HoloLens that gives us the instructions directly from a digital model where to place building elements. Now the thing is that timber is a very old material, but at the same time, now we can actually start to combine it with new technologies. So we can start to think about automation, we can start to think about robotics, we can start to think about augmented reality in combination with timber. And it's actually much easier to do that with timber than with concrete or steel, because timber is lightweight, it's easy to cut, it's easy to handle. I think today what we're also demonstrating is that this kind of digital world, that it's not anymore a far-fetched fantasy. So the challenge with these elements is they're a little bit like pixels. So the idea is that they have no specific position or role. They're universal Lego-like building blocks that need to be able to perform in any situation in the building. What we're really showing with this installation is that we can do this already today. So already today we can work with a fully automated workflow, where essentially you get instructions from a computer that are sent to a team of builders. And it's really an algorithm that is talking to a crew of builders that then position these elements and create these kind of extraordinary structures that are not something that maybe normally as a human you would come up with or design. It gives people really the experience of what it would feel like if they would be in this crazy algorithmically generated timber building, and they can experience this with their body, they can sit there, they can relax there. And it's in a way really a kind of an important experiment to show that these kind of structures are feasible, that we can build them out of very cheap and lightweight materials, that we can scale it up. What we're starting to see is that there's a lot of interest in automation and the built environment, especially in Europe. And the reason for that is that we know that the building industry is in a way very old-fashioned. It hasn't fundamentally changed for about 100 years. And we're really kind of waiting in a way to disrupt that industry and to make building more accessible to large amounts of people. And I think what we're seeing in Europe is a kind of a climate where we're more and more facing a housing crisis, where young people find it increasingly more difficult to access housing. The interesting part also about this modular workflow is that once you have the factory set up and the parts engineered, that you can replicate the same process faster and faster. So maybe the first try would take a month, but then maybe the next iterations would go increasingly faster. And then maybe we're talking in the end about a few days even. The fact that it's automated makes it very cheap to produce. It's also sustainable. It's made of a very small amount of timber. And then I think as a space, it gives something back to us. And I think that's very important, that it's not just automation for the sake of reducing cost and in a way producing something cheaply, but it's really capitalizing on automation to produce also more exciting spaces for people. These technologies already exist today. So it's about kind of incentivizing people and governments and developers to look into these technologies and understand that it's not actually from the future, that we can actually really build and construct today in this fashion, and that it would have a lot of advantages to do so.